Do you want to build an email list for your Etsy business but don't know where to start? In this video, I'm going to share with you my best tips for Etsy email marketing for beginners. I'll show you how to start an email list, how to get people on your email list, and then what to write to them after they're on your list. You don't have to offer only sales and discounts to build an email list. Welcome. If this is your first time here, my name's Cassie and I help creative people turn their crafts into cash. So let's start with how to get customers on your email list. And the first thing that I want to stress is that you absolutely cannot add previous customers to your email list manually. Etsy has terms of use and that is against their terms of use if you collect your previous Etsy customers' email addresses and market to them. However, there is a way that you can do this, and that is through an email service provider called Aweber, and they actually integrate with Etsy. And so when your customers check out, there will be a little box that offers them the option to get on your email list. So this is a way that you actually legally can collect your Etsy customers' email addresses because they are opting in by choice to receive your emails. You can actually try Aweber for free, and I will put a link in the description box so that you can check that out if you want to. And the way that you set up this integration is you set up your Aweber account, and then you're going to add Etsy to your My Apps list. And this integrates the two so that you can put that checkbox on your checkout page. The great thing about Aweber is that it's pretty straightforward and easy for beginners at email marketing to understand and get their email process going very simply. So now you know how you can get your previous customers from Etsy onto your email list, but you want to get way more people than that on your email list. So how you do that is with a free resource. So you want to make a free resource for your customers and potential customers, and they will opt in to get that freebie by giving you their email address. Now, if you don't want to make a free resource, you can definitely offer a discount code to your customers if you choose to do that. And the way that you would do that is go into your Etsy account, and on the left-hand side, the tab that says marketing, you can set up a coupon code in there, and then that would be sent to the customer in the first email that they get. So in order to create a freebie, you want to know who your target audience is and what problems that they have. And then you want to give them a quick win with this free resource that you make so that they begin to trust you. So there are quite a few different resources that you can make as your freebie. And so I'm going to give you a few ideas. You can make an ebook, a cheat sheet, a worksheet, a workbook, a guide, a checklist, a spreadsheet, a video training, an email challenge, an audio recording, a quiz, or offer a free Facebook group. You can make your free resource in Google Docs if you want to make it really simple, or Word. You would just want to save it as a PDF so that you can send it to people. You can also design something in Canva or Photoshop. Once you have your freebie set up, then you want to create an opt-in form in your email service provider. What this is a little sign-up box, and it'll have like a photo of what your freebie is, and then it'll have boxes where they can put in their information, their email address, and their name usually is what people ask for. Once your form is created in your email service provider, you'll get a link for that. If you have a website, you can put it on your website. If you have a YouTube channel, you can put it in the description box of your videos and in your Etsy shop. You can also link to it on your social media accounts. So in your Etsy shop, where you would want to put your link would be in your shop banner, your about section, your shop announcements, your product descriptions, if it fits in with the product. And another thing to consider is that people could leave your paid listing to go to your freebie, which would get them on your email list. But you might want to think about whether you really want to put the link to your freebie in your product descriptions, because it might send people away that were going to buy. So just something to consider. You can also make an image in Canva or Photoshop or something and show your freebie, and then have the link printed right there on the photo. And you can put that as one of your product listing photos to get people on your email from your photos. So now you have your opt-in form and your freebie, and you've set up a system where you have your link in multiple places so that people can find your opt-in form and get your freebie. But now you have to deliver this freebie to them, and you have to communicate with these people. So the first thing you'll want to do is set up a welcome series in your email service provider. And this will be an automated one, so that when they sign up, they will automatically get sent the first email, and then all the emails in that sequence will come after that. They'll immediately get the first email, which will be a welcome email, and it will have the link to download your freebie. And then you can introduce yourself and tell a little bit about your shop and what your mission is. Just a kind of get to know me kind of email. Then you'll want to send a few more emails to them, spaced out at least a few days. You don't want to bombard their email inbox. So in these emails, you'll want to provide them some valuable tips and tricks and advice about a problem, whatever problem your freebie was helping them solve. If you have tips and advice that are related to that, then offer that up. And in these emails also, you can make them aware of the products that you offer and tell relatable stories that can build a relationship between the two of you. You can also ask them to engage with you. So ask a question and tell them to reply to the message, and you'll get back to them. So this will help create more of a relationship between them and you, so that they feel more comfortable with you and understand who's behind this brand of yours. Now, once they've finished with this welcome series, you're going to want to keep in contact with them at least once a month, or even as often as once a week. You could do weekly or bi-weekly. And again, just offer more helpful tips and strengthen the relationship with them. Getting them to know you and like you and trust you. Sprinkle in mentions of your products, where they fit in to whatever you're talking about. And also make them aware when you add new products to your shop or launch a new product line. Remember that you want to email them consistently. And this is really a key factor, because if you don't email consistently, they're going to turn cold, they're going to unsubscribe, and they're not going to buy anything from you. So all of this work would have been for nothing. So that's why I say no less than once a month, but probably a little more often is better to keep you in the front of their mind. You know, think of it like if you had a friend and you never called them or talked to them or communicated with them in any way, eventually that friendship is just going to fizzle out. And the same exact thing will happen with these people, only faster because they don't know you well enough. You want to make sure that you keep those communication lines open and stay at the top of their mind so that they remember you and remember your products. Please give this video a like if it was helpful. And if you want to, be sure to get all of the videos in this series for promoting and marketing your Etsy shop. Be sure to hit that subscribe and bell notification button. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.